And what a big win it was for the Cats yesterday. And this young man's from Launceston. He was pick number 16 in the 2012 draft. I speak of Jackson Thurlow. Thanks for joining us on Future Stars, mate. And it was a must-win game down at the Cattery yesterday.
Yeah, it was. It was a really important game for us. We had a meeting early in the week that we didn't want to be sitting there early in September not playing finals. So I think for us to really push forward and give ourselves a chance of playing finals, the next few weeks are important as well.
It was about 2 years ago, Bill Brownless on the Sunday Footy Show said to me just off air that watch Jackson Thurlow, watch his development, he's going to be a jet of a player. And this year you're really starting to motor. You've played 12 games this year, you're starting to win a lot more of the football. How's your emergence been and how do you feel in yourself? You've developed.
Yeah, obviously this year I've played some consistent games and it's just more the fact that getting confidence from the teammates and the coaches around me. They're really really giving me duties with kick in, so just gives me confidence that they're really backing me in and to play a role each week.
It was a really good win yesterday without the skipper involved. I thought you had some great players. I thought Josh Caddy was one of them. Stevie Motlop really stepped up and kicked those three goals just between the end of the third quarter and midway through the last, which were really important as well.
Yeah, definitely. Without Joel, there was definitely going to be a bit of a hole in the midfield. And Josh Caddy really stepped up. Mitch Duncan was back and he was outstanding. And Mott's obviously in the last quarter when the game was there to be won, he stood up.
Just talk to me, Jackson, about the young players, the likes of Murdoch, Lang, Bewes, really having a good year this year. Just give us an insight on what it's like to have the blokes like Mackey, Enright, all those type of fellas to learn off every year.
Yeah, myself and Bewsy especially are really fortunate in the fact that we play down back and we've got guys like Corey Enright, Harry Taylor, Tom Lonigan that we can just pick their brain and gain as much knowledge as possible, really, because they are superstars of the game and have been around for a long time.
How did you go with the lacerated kidney over the summer months? I mean, it's a really nasty accident to have. And Tommy Lonigan, I would have thought that he would have put an arm around you pretty quick.
Yeah, it was really unfortunate. It happened 3 weeks into pre-season, so I basically didn't come back till February 1st. So I went back to Tassie for a few months, which was good to be down there, but at the same time, you never really want to miss too much of pre-season. Tom Morning was really good. He just gave me a bit of advice and offered me his kidney guard, but I don't think mine was near as bad as what he went through. He was in hospital for a long time, so I was really lucky in that regard.
I'd be playing the hurt card. I'd be saying, yeah, mine was just as bad as his. Jakey Stringer says his broken leg was as bad as mine. Clearly wasn't.
He went through hell, Tommy, so... From what I've heard, mine was nowhere near as bad as his.
Look, you need your key players there. I mean, we mentioned that Joel wasn't there yesterday, but Tommy Hawkins re-signing with the football club must have been huge for the footy club.
Yeah, I think it really was. I think it was really big for him as well. I think he's been through a lot this year and the footy club really rallied around him and I think he really appreciated that and to have him on for another 5 years is really good and we're hoping for a lot more edits like that there.
And you recently re-signed yourself for another 3 years, Jordan Murdoch as well, so they're slowly putting this young list together that could probably try and emulate what the young list of 2002, that group that came together, have done.
Yeah, definitely. Myself, Darcy Lang, Jed Bewes, I think there might be hopefully a few more in the next coming weeks, but we need to start taking these older guys to the next level and hopefully they can stay around forever, but obviously they're not going to and there needs to be guys to take their spot.
Now, Jackson, we'll pick up on your pathway. As Brownie mentioned, you're from Launceston. You played for Tassie 2 years in national championships. I remember you won the championship in the first year. We'll see some vision of you playing here.
Yeah.
But the next year in 2012, you're an All-Australian. You had 45 possessions across half-back against Vic Metro. Tell us about playing for Tassie, that wonderful spirit that the players have in representing their state.
Yeah, it is. It's a real privilege to play for Tassie. I think it sort of gets swept under the mat a bit that Tassie's just a little state and not much footy players or teams really come out of it. But a lot of people do take a lot of pride in playing in Tassie. It is a really good culture down there and the whole state really gets behind the footy team as well.
Now, Brownie, 6 weeks ago, we come on this show declaring that this man sitting next to us should have had a Rising Star nomination. Yes. Shifter, what is going on? And surely the time must be coming.
Well, we can say that the aim is to get the best 23 for the year. And each week there can be three or four well-qualified players. And again, it'll be that case this week. And so I will go to my deputies in Lenny Hayes and Brad Johnson tonight. We'll try and sort it by 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. But he's right there in contention.
Just a couple more from me. You walk into a football club that has won three premierships. What are the non-negotiables when Chris Scott speaks and obviously Joel Selwood speaks? What are the non-negotiables at the Geelong Footy Club?
First, listen. And the other one is just don't be late. If you're late to meetings, we have a thing called a minute of madness. You've got to stand up in front of the whole group and do something stupid normally, and it's not a very nice feeling. I haven't had to do it myself, but yeah.
If you're watching, kids, listen and don't be late. And the other one, there's a lot of talk that you might be the next Corey Enright. Big shoes to fill, but it's a great compliment to you that people are starting to talk about you in that manner.
Yeah, it is. It is a big compliment, but I think it's just, I'm just really enjoying the fact that I'm getting to learn off him at the moment. I get to play alongside him. He's played 302 games now, and yeah, he is a champion at footy club, so I'm just gaining as much knowledge as I can from him.
Thanks for joining us, mate. It's been a pleasure watching you develop this year, and I'm sure for the next 10 to 12 years, the Cats supporters are going to be really thankful they got you on running off the halfback flank and through the wing.
Thanks very much. Thanks for having me.